In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. We'll talk about Jonah's prayer today because sometimes we focus only on Jonah's mistakes, although his mistakes are clear. He fled from our Lord and fell asleep and despaired very quickly and asked for death for himself. He did not like the salvation of the Gentiles or Nineveh, and he blamed our Lord instead of blaming himself. Jonah is a great prophet, and his greatness lies in his prayer. Because Jonah's prayer is a school of prayer for those who want to learn to pray. Despite its brevity, it expresses the art of prayer, illustrating everything that a person needs. First off, we will talk about what Jonah's problem was and why he refused to go to Nineveh. The fathers differed in the analysis of this position and expressed many opinions, all of which complement each other and are not contradictory to one another, but some see that he was a fanatical Jew, and because Nineveh meant Assyria, a faraway pagan country, they had nothing to do with repentance. He wanted to destroy them, like the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah, and like what happened at the time of the flood. The heart of Jonah, although he was a prophet, was not like God. God's heart is much greater and kinder to humans than the hearts of human beings themselves. So the first explanation for his refusal is that he didn't care for the Gentiles and their salvation. Others say that because of the spirit of prophecy, he knew that these people would humiliate his people after 100 years. His opinion was that this people should perish today, as their future generations would murder, rape, and loot the people of Israel. And indeed, that did happen. They were very tough times. Another explanation would be rebellion, meaning he lacked obedience. I'm not going, just like a stubborn child. And Jonah was like that. These words may work with people, but they don't work with our Lord. You can't just say no to our Lord. He asks you to go, and you just turn your back and walk away? But before we slander a man and underestimate the dignity of a great prophet, let us remember that we actually do this daily with our Lord. All too often, we ignore the clear voice of our Lord when he says things like, "Forgive your brother," "Pray well," "Postpone what you're doing now and focus on God," "Do this or that good deed." And we ignore his voice. Instead of saying that Jonah is not right, we are not that better off ourselves. Another reason that St. Cyril the Great and some of the fathers gave was that Jonah was afraid because Nineveh is a pagan country that does not know our Lord, and he never left the Jews' land. The request was difficult for him. He was requested to go to a far, strange, and big country to people who are predatory by nature and who could murder him instantly. Furthermore, the message he was delivering was tough. That is, after 40 days, the city will be overturned. What does that even mean? They'll get rid of him. He might have been afraid because he was accustomed to speaking only with his people. He keeps contemplating which language to use, how they'll greet him, whether they will accept him or not, and of course, he is not expecting the whale and the situations that will happen along the way. Also, before we say prophets should not be afraid and weak, we must admit that we get afraid every day, and because of fear, sometimes we mistreat our Lord. Jonah had another problem, which was he was quick to get upset and despair. Before you say he shouldn't, we must also say that we're also quick-tempered. As the boat was sinking, the sailors asked him what to do to him. He tells them to throw him into the sea. "But Jonah, you'll die." "Yes, I'll die, but what am I going to do anyway?" "Just like that, Jonah? Just die and go to hell? Wouldn't that be a great loss?" This goes to show us that when anxiety possesses somebody, their closest option becomes death. Even the sailors stood in his way and tried to help and save the boat, but he refused and said, "Just throw me into the sea." Then when our Lord saved Nineveh and the 40th day had passed, Jonah said, "Look, Lord, take me because you fulfilled what you'd said." Some of the fathers said that he was afraid that what he proclaimed to them would not happen, that after 40 days nothing would happen to the city, as he knew that our Lord was good. He thought if he said that and they repented and God didn't destroy the city, he'd appear to be a liar. They did not know that our Lord forgave them when they repented, so he was attending to his reputation, and this was a clear reason in chapter 4. However, speaking about despair, he said to the Lord, "Take me." Jonah is it reasonable to ask the Lord to take you because people repented or because your word didn't actually occur? It was not your word in the first place. It was God's. Then a third situation occurred when a plant came up to give him shade and soothe his nerves. Then a worm caused the plant to die, and again Jonah was upset with God and again asked the Lord to take him. The Lord explained that he did not spend much effort on such a small plant and it wasn't worth that anger. People often wish death upon themselves at moments of discomfort and difficulty, but it's not really worth that. The important thing is that Jonah has many weaknesses, but what concerns us today is his prayer.